want to thank you, Ernie.
Oh, anytime, Kerm. So tell me, what were you boys doing down there by the edge of the swamp?
Edge of the swamp? We weren't at the edge of the swamp. We were right here, tasting pond scum.
Pond scum, yeah.
Oh, really?
No. Actually, we were just bobbing for stink bars.
We were bobbing.
Yeah. Would you believe we were studying ophthalmology?
No. Okay, Ernie, we were at the swamp's edge, but only because we're curious about what's out there beyond the swamp.
Ain't nothing out there but trouble.
Huh?
Shiny wheeled beasts and rubber pant wearing human beings.
Them humans don't scare me. Well, why, if you didn't come along, I would have hopped on their heads and said, "Get out of here, you humans, you."
Don't you ever talk to humans. Animals that talk to humans get killed and cooked and eaten alive.
Oh, how unpleasant.
Wait a second. How could you be eaten alive if you were already killed, huh?
Oh, they have their way.
For the rest of the day, Goggles and Croaker and I talked about what Ernie had said, that we should never leave the swamp and never, ever talk to humans. We knew Ernie was probably right, but sometimes knowing you shouldn't do something makes you want to do it even more.
Oh, the fireflies are on. We better head home, guys.
Light yet filling.
Hey, guys. Do you think Arnie's right about what's outside the swamp?
Nah, he's just trying to scare us.
Well, he did a very good job. Imagine getting killed and cooked.
And eaten alive. Centipede and barley soup, my favorite.
Table for your brothers and sisters.
Sure, Ma. Dinner, guys. Bath time. Bedtime. I forgot about potty time.